Okay guys, we're still at Internet Freedom Forum. I'm here with Director of Programs at Paradigm Initiative. So help me welcome Tope Ogundipe. Welcome to my channel.
Thank you for being here with us.
So, it's been an amazing two, three days, and there's a lot of conversations about Paradigm Initiative's digital work around digital rights. And then there's a little bit of digital inclusion. Paradigm Initiative also had a side session on digital inclusion. So can you let us know what's the correlation? Rights are rights. So what's the inclusion with digital?
Okay, I think we cannot accept that we cannot accept the benefits of information and communication technology, and that more of our lives, more of public and private services are moving online. More of work, more of opportunities, more of financial transactions, even more of entertainment, you know. And of course, it has become the main channel of communication throughout the world. So I think everybody accepts the benefits and that it is very important for everyone to have access right now. So the conversation around inclusion is that we cannot even begin to talk about digital rights without starting from access, like people having access to ICTs and being able to use. So we think that is the first thing. And Africa has a penetration rate of just about 21%. So we think that that is a huge problem. And the reason why we have included the conversation around digital inclusion this year is to understand better what are the challenges or the barriers that continue to make these numbers to be that low, and what are those areas, that require focused policy advocacy for us to be able to close this gap? What are the collaborations that we need to give attention to be able to evolve digital solutions that solve our problem on the continent? So that's the basis of the conversation.
That's interesting. So you talked about collaborations and policies. So what policies have you identified as regards digital inclusion and syncing them with digital rights work?
So what we've done in terms of digital inclusion is mostly capacity building. For years, we've done capacity building in Northern Nigeria, where we have a center in Kano, and in Southeast, where we have a center in Aba, and in the West, where we have a center in Lagos. But then the more you do, the more you realize that you can only do so much, and you need comprehensive policy frameworks that prescribe programs that are specific on programs, not just mentioning the issues of the divide between the rural and urban areas, or the divide between men and women, but speak to specific programs of government that private sector, public sector, civil society can then be partners, implementing partners, programs that have specific budgetary allocations, and so what we are doing is just what a single civil society can do, and that's why it's very important for us to have this conversation around policy, to begin to look at programs that actually target populations that are least likely to adopt. There are a number of things that we have talked about, considered in our conversation here. We even started from talking about measurement in terms of what we need to measure, and just identifying where the gaps really are. We were looking at what national ICT data exists and how empirical, and if it is sexually segregated and all of that. And research as a way to begin to inform advocacy. We also talked about the fact that even though a lot of the regulation in Nigeria, for instance, is focused on opening and liberalizing the market, but there are other market indicators that still shows that we need to do more. We need to do more in terms of quality of service. We need to do more in terms of skills and education, you know, such that it's not just access, but what people do with access, what skills they have to be able to have social inclusion through access. So those are the kind of those are kind of policy directions that we're looking at, and the collaborations were in terms of one, mapping the landscape to find out who is doing what, so that we are not duplicating efforts and wasting resources and doing more together, and then also identifying like priority areas and having progress incrementally to say this is the first thing we're going to do, and then we're going to do this next one in terms of how we advocate, and not, you know, like have a long list of demands and say, you know, do that, but to be strategic, to identify what the priorities are for government with regards to the digital economy and it's the will to diversify right now and to create jobs and employment and all the technology plans, and to begin to engage on those levels as a coalition of civil society organizations that are working around the mission.
IFF is in its sixth year.
Yes.
And it's growing by the day, by the year.
But
what are the
immediate
plans for IFF
2019? Okay, it is difficult for me to sit with you right now and talk about what exactly will happen in 2019, because it is something that we need to plan with the argument. But to answer the question of what we are considering in the future, we definitely are considering another location on the continent for IFF future, in order to have even more Pan-African participation. We definitely are considering collaboration with other organizations that do similar events on the continent, and how we can achieve synergy and do more with what we are doing. So we are, there are a number of initiatives that we're considering, and we're also considering having this in the future as a digital rights and inclusion forum. As a way to also create more synergy between all of the programs that we do as part of our initiative. So these are ideas we are toying with to hold it in other locations, hold it in, you know, like in collaboration with similar events, instead of having an event that is very similar to IFF, you know, in Kenya and Ghana, and then the next month in Nigeria, and we can do all of those things together, and if it is more valuable to do that, we are open to considering that. I would definitely open to considering another location outside of Nigeria.
Thank you so much for your time, and thank you for your time.
Yes, thank you. Please subscribe to this channel. I think it's very valuable. I subscribed myself, and I constantly visit this channel. I find it very useful. So please, yeah, subscribe. Now, thank you.